Welcome. I'm here with our Permeable Pavement Masterclass speaker, David Hein, to tell you a little more about his expertise. So Dave, you work for Applied Research Associates. Tell us a little about what you do there.
Well, for the last 15 years, I have been a principal engineer at ARA. For the last 13 years, I've been a division manager. I'm responsible for about 100 folks who deal with pavement design, evaluation, and management, research, software development, etc. The group works extensively throughout North America, as well as in many countries overseas. We have projects on the go in Europe and South America and Asia as well. Else, my particular position, what I do is primarily project management more these days than so much the technical evaluations. I do a lot of work in helping people manage their assets. That's at the municipal, at the state or provincial level, as well as a great deal of work for highway concession type contracts. We are extensively involved in public-private partnership projects around North America. We typically have between 5 and 10 of them on the go at a particular time. Our work ranges from helping with the operations management, life cycle costing, how will they manage the infrastructure for the next 25 to 50 years, for example. What kind of tools do they need, what kind of practices do they need, what kind of specifications and contracting practices that they require to optimize their investments. Anything in that just doesn't go just for P3s, it actually goes for municipalities and state departments, so highway departments as well. My group also administers the Federal Highway, Federal Highway Administration contracts, including the Everyday Counts Initiative, which is trying to improve and optimize how we deliver transportation services, how we take those services and help people implement them at the state and local levels as well. So the feds will look at particular ideas in terms of how we can make things, the roads safer, how we can make them more last longer, basically to be more sustainable, and then we help others to implement those processes.
Sounds like they keep you busy out there. You're also the chair of the ASCE T&DI Permeable Pavement Structural Design Committee. What do you do in this position?
Well, I've been doing a lot of work for ASCE for many, many years. It's a very large organization, almost 200,000 engineers worldwide who are the process of what they do is to try and advance the world of civil engineering. I got involved with them through the initial development of a standard for the design of interlocking concrete block pavements, so conventional ones. That was a standard that was released. It's called ASCE 5810. It was released in 2010, obviously. And I did not initially chair that committee, but the chair was moving on, basically, and they were looking for somebody else to take it over. So as a contributor to that committee, I became the chair and finished up the development of that standard. As a part of that, I was then approached to develop the current standard that we're producing, which is on the design, construction, and maintenance of permeable interlocking concrete pavement. We've had 10 meetings over the last couple of years. It includes a wide range of groups of people who have the experience in the structural design and specifying a pavement infrastructure, but also, and the interesting part is that we have a huge group, half of the group basically, that is into the water resources and water standards type approach. So we're marrying those two groups together to produce a consensus standard that will go to ballot later this year and hopefully be published before the end of the year. In the interim, ASCE is also produced, the Environmental Water Resources Institute has just released, literally 2 weeks ago, a committee document which is also on the design, construction, and maintenance of permeable pavements, which is not a standard, but it basically provides good guidance to people who want to consider potentially using permeable pavements. And I was one of the technical editors for that particular document, and then subsequent to that, I've been asked now to chair a new standards committee on the design, construction, and maintenance of porous asphalt pavement. So there are several types of products that can be used to make a pavement permeable, and so the ultimate goal of ASCE is to do the same thing for potentially grid pavements as well as concrete, pervious concrete pavements, to develop one overall combined standard for the design, because there's definitely some overlaps with those two areas. And so that standard activity is actually just commencing now, and we're probably going to be 2 to 2.5 years or so before we actually publish that particular one.
Great. We'll have to check out those new resources. I know you have worked at many universities and spoken for many associations. What do you like most about sharing your expertise?
Wow, well, that's a great question, actually, and it's one that comes very close to mind. In fact, yesterday and Saturday, I was at the Transportation Association of Canada spring meetings we have. It's similar to our Transportation Research Board mid-summer meetings. And I sit on what's called the Education and Human Resources Development Council. A council is above a committee level. It's providing input directly to the board of directors. The Transportation Association of Canada is in 101st year. It's older than the Transportation Research Board in Washington, D.C. The purpose of the organization is to enhance transportation and bring knowledge to transportation professionals, particularly in the engineering field across the country. And so I joined this council almost 10 years ago because I do really, really very much enjoy mentoring younger folks and bringing folks along. And so we do a lot of things relating from everything from the ethics of engineering to technical expertise to interaction and coordination with groups in both the U.S. and Canada to, again, advance the state of transportation. As a part of that, as you mentioned, I also get to speak at universities and a lot of other industry and other society events, et cetera, and I'm a regular speaker at these type of things. Just recently did some out in British Columbia. I was down in Texas a couple of weeks ago. I spoke at my alma mater, University of Waterloo, Ontario. I do that on a regular basis. In fact, Wednesday, I'm doing a session for 2 hours with a group of young folks on pavement condition data needs and challenges and things like that. And so I have never learned how to say no to that kind of thing, which is unfortunate because it really sucks up a lot of my time. But it's very rewarding. And it's very rewarding to see people get it. You know, it's a complicated business we're in, and when you have the ability to explain something to someone simply, they understand it better, and different people understand things differently. And so the highly technical people are expecting some technical approach, and those that are not so technical, you know, really don't understand it unless you break it down into elements they can understand. So that's one of the things I seem to be reasonably good at. So people like to listen to what I have to say because I get quite a bit of experience, but also its ability to communicate it in the fashion that they can quickly understand it.
Well, we're glad you never say no to a good teaching opportunity. And one last question. What do you like most about your work?
I like helping folks. I like helping, I became an engineer to help people solve problems. And I very much cling to the principle that keep it simple is the best way to do that. So complexity, you know, there are very, very complex systems, and building spaceships and all the rest of that kind of stuff, you know, inherently have to be somewhat complex. But complexity to me is an excuse for bad design, because if you can't think of a way to do it simple, you're likely going to have to take on risks and things like that that will potentially not be required. And the more complicated things are, the more probability you have the potential for failure or something in there that's going to make your life difficult in the future. So I like taking complicated things and thinking about them, you know, sometimes long periods of time, but bringing together a bunch of folks to help simplify things. It's amazing what you can do when you bring the right minds and the right people together to make things simple. So, that probably is, you know, making things simple for people to do their jobs better and to understand why we do things.
I agree. Simplicity is always best. Well, that's all we have time for today. If you want to learn more from Dave, check out his 4-session Permeable Pavement Masterclass series available at forestryuniversity.net and his other videos on our ForestryU YouTube channel.